this can be a very short video, because the answer to how to use an e-collar the right way is very simple. Don't use it at all. Or you can do this. Don't take my word for it. Read some of the papers that I linked in the description below. If you don't have time for it, this is why you shouldn't use an e-collar, electronic, electric collar, shock collar, or even citronella or anti-bark collars. 1. Welfare. Dogs that were trained with e-collars were more likely to show signs of stress and anxiety compared to dogs that were trained in different ways that were non-aversive. This means that training your dog with an e-collar might actually damage the human-dog bond and will create a very stressful dog that doesn't trust you. Do you think that if you know how to use the e-collar correctly, then your dog will be fine? Sadly, this is not the case, because in the studies they were actually using trainers that were recommended by the manufacturer of those collars. Those trainers were like the elite trainers using the e-collar methods. 2. Why use methods that hurt your dog and are painful and scary when you can use other methods that use positive reinforcement? You can think about dogs like toddlers, human toddlers. Would you use an e-collar on a toddler? Probably not, because you know that they will not understand the punishment. They will not make the connection between the punishment and what they did. And even if they do, it will just make them afraid of you. 3. Efficiency. When the researchers compared the different methods of training, the e-collars were pretty much the same or even less effective than the other training methods. That means that if they were even the same as the other methods, why actually use them? Why cause pain and hurt your dog? And that basically brings me back to the second point that I made. If there are alternatives, why not use them? 4. Health. Depending on how you use it, you might actually cause health issues. Usually, where the electricity goes into the skin, you might see puncture wounds or even burns. Also, the neck is full of very important organs, for example, the thyroid. There are no studies on the long-term effects of those collars on, for example, the function of the thyroid. I wouldn't recommend anyone to do an experiment on their dog and see how it affects their dog in the long run. Would you? 5. Legislation. Did you know that the number of countries that are banning the use of all of those e-collars is rising? And even in the countries that they banned the use of e-collars, you don't see a crazy rise in dog attacks. It might take a while before those collars are banned all around the world, but why not prepare yourself to that time and choose a method that is here to stay, the force-free method. I assume that most people that were so convinced that using an e-collar is the best method in the world already left after my first sentence. But for those of you who stayed, hi, I'm Dr. Orion, a veterinarian and a veterinary behavior residency graduate. This means that I actually work with many of these dogs that are crazy and can't be trained in any other way except for those aversive and scary methods. And you know what? I didn't use an e-collar with any of them and they still got better. But now you have access to science, so please click below and see what the actual studies are telling you. If you still have questions or concerns about what you should do with your dog, please feel free to comment below or even join my subreddit group. I'm also going to link that in the description of the video. If you want to learn what the best method to training dogs is, please click this video.